The use of superalloy materials is increasing in the future. The need to manufacture parts quicker and more reliable is critical. And because of this, cost reduction and productivity improvements need to be implemented. As a metal removal and cost reduction technique, ceramic milling is an exceptional solution. The most common application for ceramic milling is in engine casings due to the high stock removal required between the bosses. And in this episode, we will focus on key points to consider when applying ceramic milling. A common way to machine superalloy materials is to use carbide. The problem is these materials generate very, very high temperatures. This causes rapid wear in conventional carbide inserts. To avoid this, you need to use low cutting speeds. However, of course, this results in long cycle times and poor productivity. The solution is to apply ceramic milling. Key to successful ceramic milling is first of all to run with the optimized cutting speed. Typical cutting speed for carbide milling is around 30 meters per minute or 90 surface feet. With ceramic milling, the cutting speed needs to be elevated to 1,000 meters per minute or 3,300 surface feet. And this is more than 30 times higher than carbide. When using carbide inserts in superalloy machining, coolant should always be applied. However, the opposite can be said when milling using ceramics. You should never apply coolant when ceramic milling. This creates thermal shock and has a negative effect on tool life. It's also really important to apply the optimized chip thickness. Round inserts are by far the most common in ceramic milling. But remember to compensate your feed rate according to the cutting depth to achieve the maximum productivity. And a good starting value to use is around 0.1 millimeters per tooth or 4 thou. So in summary, ceramic milling can provide dramatic cost savings when applied the correct way. But we really need to remember the key points to be successful. A cutting speed of around about 1,000 meters per minute or 3,300 surface feet. No coolant to help reduce thermal shock. And a chip thickness of around 0.1 millimeters or 4 thou per tooth. For more smart tips, contact one of our specialists or visit us at the Sandvik Coromant website.